Now, our next guest says the West has given up creative thinking in favour of creative blinking in the face of innovation from Asia. So are the US and European continents losing the battle of the brains? Joining us for more, Dr. Hal Ravache, President at the Stevens Institute of Technology. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you, Ross.
For joining us. Why do you say we're losing the innovation skills that we've had for so long? What's the evidence?
Ross, the fundamentals are the evidence. So if you look at the number of patents per resident, not multinational company, first is Japan, close second Korea, third is Taiwan, big gap comes the US. Big gap comes the UK after that, lower. If you look at the number of patents coming out of universities, long thought to be a major driver, it's plateaued in the United States over the past decade. If you look at the number of independent public offerings in the United States, they have plummeted. If you look at the way accounting firms allow for firms to write off research and development as a pad to equipment or plant, very different. They have to subtract the full value of the R&D investment and only a fraction of the equipment. Sarbanes-Oxley is terrible. We've thrown the baby out with the bathwater, if you will.
Are you saying, in the United States, are you saying that some of the reasons for this downturn is actually in the structure and the law changes that we've had?
Yes, of course. It's a combination of a lack of innovation and then the chilling effect.
It's not that people fundamentally are less innovative, it's just that their innovation is being strangled a bit.
No, Ross, it's both, because the CEOs, I'm afraid, have taken the easy way out. Mm. So we can manufacture a product in the US, a high-tech product, and its final price will be as competitive with China if we use innovation every step of the process.
Right.
And still pay $30 an hour in the US with health benefits. But we've given up. The easy way is outsource your jobs to lower your costs and appear to be more profitable. But the fundamentals aren't there because for the long term, you're not investing in R&D and you don't have the new products and services in the pipeline to really drive the market so that your investors who watch this show, you know, can do better.
The point being is that we are now starting to see, I guess, you know, cost of labor going up around the world. I mean, the great decade, the benefit of globalization, outsourcing may well be over to a degree.
No, Ross. It'll move around. It'll go from China to India to Vietnam to Thailand.
And wages are going up in all those countries.
Yes, but it's a different scale.
It's the comparatives.
Yes.
So it's going to keep moving around.
Yes. We tell our students, right, that if you're just a good engineer or scientist, you can be outsourced. But if you know how to add value to your organization, then it's less likely that you'll be outsourced.
So the value bit comes back
it's
to this
innovation. It's what is innovation? It's creating a new product, service, or process and extracting its value. It's not just the invention and the creation, extracting the value.
Why is this a reversible trend? How does one reverse the trend that you've identified?
It has to come from the top. And if you've noticed, the major element in the presidential election is change, right? Mm. But what are we changing to? No one's really defining
it. Well, they haven't told us that.
No. Well, we're waiting. We Americans are waiting. So what are we changing to? So it has to come from the top of the private sector as well as the public sector. A mindset. It can't be just a little program off in the corner. A whole mindset. I'm leaving for Singapore on Monday from London, okay? I spend a lot of time in Singapore and Korea and Taiwan and Malaysia. When you visit those countries, they are acutely aware of competition. Mm. And they know they have to get up earlier and stay up later to do better.
Sort of like training for the Olympics. You've got to be as good as you're
or the Navy SEALs.
So why have we lost this awareness of competition?
A little complacency, a little confident thinking we were the best. We count the number of Nobel laureates in the United States and say, oh, we're the highest in the world. And, you know, we relax. It's not good.
Although I never bet against the United States just because of what's inbuilt into it. And it is such a big single economy. And there's plenty of entrepreneurs in there. So, essentially, with a change of culture, you could release that.
Oh, I'm betting four. We have to change the culture. We have to give ourselves a shot of vitamin B12, right? And say, okay, let's bring back the American spirit. How do we wrestle the economy from Britain when we were first born? Manufacturing.
It's an interest. I feel like I should take you out for a beer and we should talk about this further. But good to see you. Thank you so much for coming in. Dr. Hal Ravache, President of the Stevens Institute of Technology.